Hey guys, welcome back to Emperor, and in this part we're going to continue building Kaifeng. Now in the previous part we started to build up our silk industry as well as our weapons industry because we're going to have to build more forts for the rule for cities requirement. We also started to build up our main housing blocks to try and boost our population because as you can see it's a bit erratic, and over here we've got an erratic food supply as well. We do still have an issue with spies in the city, which is not too good. We also started building up an elite block so that we can start getting more houses in. And the hemp is too distant, I thought, as much. Let's set this to tasty food. Let's see, let's set this to accept hemp, which it is, but not enough is reaching it. So I might have to put down more hemp farms, I think. Yeah, our main housing block is all over here, but and all the stuff is over here, but it means that these ones are on the other side of the walled complex. In hindsight, I could have put maybe some elite houses in this complex, but it doesn't seem to make any difference at all, so no worries. What I'll do is I'll just go ahead and put down another farm, I think, because we'll need one. So let's see, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. By putting it 1, 2, 3, so it needs to go out like. Actually, let's not put that farm just there. Let's just rework this a bit. Actually, no. Let's just go put the farm here. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. And roadblock. And put down a hemp field just here. Which works, that's fine. So we'll get more hemp into the city as well. How to keep an eye out for spies, because they are in this city and they can do a lot of damage. We're selling our silk to Pingyao. We're making so much silk that we can't sell it now all to them. So we really need to try and find someone else who's buying silk. Now, if I remember correctly, Guancho buys silk, but we need to try and... let's actually give them 8 bolts of silk, since we've got loads of it. And we'll just open them up and then conquer them. I think they're a water trader. No, there's a spy. Caught him. Which is good. And there's another one. Yeah, we do have an issue of spies in this city, so... not too good. Let's see if there's any more. I know there was one kind of wandering around here stealing stuff out of the workshops, which wasn't too good. And we also need to get someone who buys sells us lacquer, because that's going to be needed. I'm going to put down 2 more of those now. Does anyone sell lacquerware directly? Just a quick look. No. It has to be lacquer. So we're going to have to open up a trade route with Chengdu. So I'm going to try and build up my military forces, because we do need to conquer loads of cities. 4 of these enemy cities need to be conquered. We're not going to conquer Pingyao or Chizhou, that's just silly. So what we're going to do is start building up the military. I'm going to try and get this stable because it's not really all that stable, and we could do better, I suppose. I'm also going to try and set up a trading post down here for Guancho and just sell silk to them. Or here, actually, I might be able to get it just there, and I can just draw the road up this bit here. It'll have to be harmonious balanced regardless, because of the fact of how everything's built. So this is still not getting hemp, which is not too good. So we've got hemp coming in though, so I think that'll be okay. So what I'm going to do is let this run, try to stabilise our food supplies. I'll also try to build up our military a bit more, because we're going to need to do that. And I'll come back in once the Guancho trading post, the trade route, has been opened. So our housing is starting to stabilise. See, we've got a lot of unemployment that I need to get rid of. Still got an issue with spies, and trade with Guancho has now opened up. I also managed to get Sun Tzu in here. Hopefully he'll help to capture all these bloody spies. Let's just catch him. I'll have to use Sun Tzu to get rid of them all permanently, because they are getting annoying, I have to say. So I'll use Sun Tzu to get rid of them and then send them away. I might not even send them away at all, I might just catch them and be done with it. So our houses haven't really evolved because they haven't got access to tasty food yet. There is 4 food types in here, so that's not too big of a deal. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, so it's 4 food types, that's okay. We've got access to hemp, which is good enough. So let's go ahead and put down, well, let's just take one look, final look for spies. No spies here. So what I'm going to do is leave Sun Tzu just around here. I'll keep giving him silk every so often just to keep him in the city, and then use it to capture spies. So Guangzhou is a water trade route, if I remember correctly. Yes. Let's put this here. Like so. And then, oh, that's not going to fit in there, I don't think. Let's just delete that and move it along by one more tile. Like so. And then this, and then roadblock, and then start selling silk, loads of silk to Guangzhou, because we need to start making money. Who's this that's coming through here? Oh, it's just the drama person. Okay, so our city seems stable, we just need to get rid of this unemployment issue. We've got some more lavish Sahirans, and they're also now requiring access to wares, so... let's put down more forts. Where's my cursor? There it is. Can I get this just on the edge here? No, it's just in the way, so let's put down one. Come on. This thing is such a pain in the neck to get right, isn't it? Let's put that there. And another one there. And if we just extend this down a bit, we'll be able to get more forts down this bit. So that's a 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Like so. I might actually just sort this out later, because there's a lot of stuff to sort out there. So, oh, there's a spy there, let's catch him. Maybe we'll find another spy around here somewhere. Usually when one spy appears, you usually get a rush of them, so it's not too big of a deal. So now that we've put down some more forts, we killed off some of the unemployed, or they walked right into the thing and disappeared. What a shame. So we'll start to pile up the silk in this little corner here and start really, really making some money out of it, because we are going to need to make money. How's Sun Tzu doing? Oh, he's happy. Let's give him 4 bowls of silk, and that'll keep him exalted. No other issues to speak of. I don't see any spies, but as I said, this is a pretty spy-heavy campaign, this. So I need to build up my military and start getting towards that real city's goal. We're going to try and get Chengdu captured first. So what I'm going to do is let this run and build up our military and come back in if anything interesting happens. Finally captured a spy. Just there. Captured an enemy spy in our city and we know where he came from. We have convinced his greedy folks to work for us, so he's returning to Jiangling to spy there. Well, nope, he's not. I saw him coming down here, so I just moved Sun Tzu straight to position and he captured him immediately. So we got rid of one spy, so hopefully... I'm not going to send spies off to other cities, there's no point. Alright, here comes another one now. Is he going to go cross-country or is he going to go along the roads? Let's see. Let's put Sun Tzu there. Is he going to go along the roads? No, he's going straight down here, so let's move Sun Tzu into position as quickly as we can. Quickly. Oh, is he going to go down the forts? Is he? No, he's going over here. Come on, hurry. I want to capture the spy. I think Sun Tzu will get there just in the nick of time to catch this spy. Oh, no, he's not. We'll just have to get rid of him. But he'll come back again, I think. But they're all coming down here, really, to get the stuff that they want. So, we captured one spy, lost one. So there's still one in the city somewhere, but it's not such a big deal, really. So again, I'll let this run, and I'll come back in once our forts are built up, and then we'll start trying to conquer Chengdu. So I thought I'd just come in and just give you kind of an update. I've decided to set this market square to only get plain food and try and devolve this, because we have way too many people in the city, as you can see, and I don't have anywhere to put them. But when we come back here in the second Kaifeng, we'll be able to get rid of some of the unemployment so we can boost that. But our forts are going along very, very slowly because we're not really making enough weapons. And that's because we're not importing much steel. Now, I checked on the Guangzhou trading post, and they do sell steel, so I'm importing a bit more steel from there to supplement the very limited that I'm importing from Pingyao. So it's going to take a very, very long time to staff all these forts and to conquer Chengdu, because that's the problem, because I need to evolve these houses a bit more so I can put down even more forts. And then that'll solve the issue as well. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We need another 4 forts. And I decided to put them like this because then they'll fit 9. How many scat long is it? 1, 2, 3, 4, so 9, 10, 11, and then maybe just one at the bottom there. Or maybe just one down here, and then we'll have 12. And then that'll be our maximum. So, got a bit of a problem trying to get enough weapons, and no one sells weapons. It's just a little bit of steel that you have to import. And that's the main problem with this particular dynasty's campaign. It's just importation of tiny amounts of steel to make all the weapons you need for all the massive military that you require. So what we're going to do is let this run and just come back in once all our forts are staffed, and then we'll go and conquer Chengdu. Oh, here's a notice that I haven't expected. Guangzhou vulnerable. Most honorable Super Sajuuk, spies report that Anguo, leader of your Chinese rival Guangzhou, has sent most of his military forces away from the city. Guangzhou is virtually defenseless. Interesting, so basically it sounds as if he sent some of his troops away so we could conquer him. It's interesting because the only people who are building up their military are Yu Zhang and Ping Yao. Everyone else is just one bar, so I'll still send spies to sabotage their military to keep them from trying to build up a military, and then I'll go and conquer Chengdu. I don't think I'm going to bother with Guangzhou as a one of those, but it doesn't matter. I just realised that we're just about to meet the 36 months of heroes goal because of the heroes being in the city. I completely forgot about that goal, so our troops are getting there. Slowly, they're getting there, but we're not really getting very far in terms of getting one fort up to full stat, but the weapons are getting made at a much quicker pace now that we're importing steel from multiple places. I've also set up Ping Yao to buy more silk because we weren't making much money. We're up above our starting cash now, which is good, so we've returned on our starting funds, so we've made a profit. And so again, I'll just let this run and I'll come back in when our forts are stable and we're ready to conquer Chengdu. So we've got enough troops, I've counted it. I'm not going to send off all forts, because if I do that, the game is going to obviously cause trouble for us. I noticed that Yu Zhang and Tan Zhou have gone displeased, which is not too good, but it's okay. So we're going to conquer Chengdu first so we can get access to lacquer, and obviously jade, because then I can make up a little carved jade industry somewhere and sell some carved jade, but there's not much space for it because, as you can see, everything's a bit crammed in. So I might get rid of like maybe one of these warehouses or just move them around a bit, just put them down here. I don't know, but we'll see. Anyway, first things first. Now, to conquer cities, I've already shown you how to really conquer cities, but since it's been such a long time since there's been a mission which required it, I'm going to kind of go through it again. Right? Basically, you need a lot of military power to conquer cities, so that's why I've been kind of waiting around trying to build up my troops here, because you need lots of troops. As I said before, if you send all your troops away to do this, you will just be invaded because the game will see empty forts. And the game will then send you as we can send invasions. So, first things first, train a spy to go and sabotage military, and then wait for the spy to say that your spy is busy sabotaging the military industry or whatever. That might result in a spy ending up in your city, but it's not such a big deal. So what we're going to do is let that spy head off and start sabotaging industries, the military industry at Chengdu. The reason for that is that you want to prevent him or them from trying to rebuff your attack by growing their military and defeating you, which is not good. Then what you do is you send a proportionate number of soldiers to go and target, to go and conquer that city. Just a little note, any city that's got 6 shields, you can't conquer them. You've got to use a spy to get rid of some of their shields, so just be aware of that. And so we are going to send off 6 full forts and leave 2 behind, because the 2 that are left behind will keep the game seen as we are not weak. So that's why we're doing that. I'm going to put down a couple of Jade Carver Studios here actually. I might have to move some of this stuff around because it's kind of getting in the way. because we don't have much space. So I might get rid of this warehouse and just put all that along here. Just have a mixture of silk and carved jade. It doesn't really matter because we're not going to make our money out of carved jade at the moment. We'll be doing that when we come back to this mission. So our spy's gone off. So it says, your spy is heading to Chengdu to sabotage the enemy cities. So we'll just let this run a bit more. Oops. And see when it says that they're now sabotaging the military industry. Right, so now it should say, your spy is sabotaging the military industry at Chengdu. So now that we've got that, conquered this city. Now what I'm going to do is, before we do anything, let's get a hero in here. Because having a hero has every other chance of improving success. I'm going to send some paper because that's cheaper than silk. And I put down this warehouse here to accept some paper. There are a couple of bad harmony buildings. I counted four, so that's not too bad. Two warehouses and two inspector's posts, if I remember correctly. So that's not too bad. So Sun Tzu should appear in the city shortly. Because he's exalted, so it should get him here quickly. You always want a military hero to go with you because then that improves your chances, essentially. If I remember correctly, Sun Tzu is for infantry. Yes, infantry troops. He reduces the travel time of armies sent on conquest missions. So that's why we're going to have Sun Tzu, because he makes them go faster to get there. It just means that we're not going to have trouble with spies because then we won't be able to get rid of them until he comes back. So I'll come back in once Sun Tzu's appeared. There he is. Right, so what we're going to do is move Sun Tzu over here. You don't really need to use his call troops button because that doesn't matter. Okay, so I'm going to take a save because the reason for that is you want to save before any conquer events just in case it goes wrong. You've got a point to just reload from, right? So we're going to send 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 troops and Sun Tzu. Let's set the tribute type to, let's not set it to cash because that's boring. Let's set it to that they have to give us jade. Harsh is not necessary. Let's set it to normal, no. Let's set it to mild, okay. Invasion location doesn't matter. Aggressiveness, fierce dragon, that'll do. So, I think they're a walled city, so this might not go very well, but we'll see. Yeah, it's a fortified city, so we might have some trouble with this, but hopefully it won't go too badly, because we've got Sun Tzu. So we're dispatching 6 forts and Sun Tzu to go and capture Chengdu, and they're going to give us a tribute of jade. So let's send them off. There they go. Which 6 troops did we send? We sent all of these troops, which is perfect. Sun Tzu's just disappeared from the map as soon as that happened. So he's off. So those troops are going to head off and conquer Chengdu for us, and hopefully that won't have too much repercussions. We'll have to send him a large gift of wheat to stop them getting upset though. So I'll let this run and I'll come back in once the troops have returned. Well, once we get the notification that Chengdu has been conquered, or not. We've conquered Chengdu. More sphere super Sajuuk, your army was victorious at Chengdu and its leader Ango is shamed. Chengdu now owes his tribute. That's a mistake because we've already got someone called Ango at Guangzhou, so I think that's just a mistake. Right, so let's have a look. They're now trading with us. They go bitter when you capture someone, so you have to send them a gift rather early. So let's get rid of that spy, we don't need him. All we'll do is we'll send a large gift of wheat to Chengdu and that'll get them to loyal. So we're now trading with Chengdu by default because of a vassal, so we'll send off the wheat, that'll keep them happy. And then we have access to lacquer, so... Magnificent Super Sajuuk, I am Go of Chengdu, I'm trying hard to comply with your just demands for tribute. Regrettably, the problem is I have 4 piles of uncut jade that you request, but you don't have the space to store it. Well, here's some space. So let's import they import 36 casks of lacquer, that is a lot. We really don't need that much, so let's just set that to 12. Let's find a space to start up a little carved jade industry, I think. So let's just pause. I can't really put any here, but we can put forts along this bit here. Right. 10. I love it. I don't think that'll fit in there, but we might have some spaces around here, but it doesn't matter, so... What I'll do is I'll destroy some of these trees, because I don't think we need tons of these trees, and I'll set up a little industry over here for making carved jade that we can sell to Guancho straight off. So let's just destroy these trees. Like so, since we don't really need access to all of them. Now, where's the bridge? Let's just pause for a second. Like so. And let's just put down carved jade in here, and we'll just accept a little bit of jade in there as well. So we'll put down 1, 2, 3. We'll set this up. I'll get rid of this because I don't need it anymore, so that's that sorted, and I can just straighten the road up like so. Oops. Popularity is beginning to sink for some reason, that's not too good. I'll just do that, and that makes it easier because then I can just have one right across here like so. So we've got some employees needed, so that means we're going to have to start boosting houses, I think. Well, we'll do that in a minute. So let's hope that that gift of wheat to Chengdu has helped, because yeah, there's the 4 piles of uncut jade. Let's import more jade from Chengdu. We'll set it to 8. Since I'm having to go some distance, I don't think we'll need anything around the outer edges here, so let's just set this to only 4 jade, because that's all we're going to be getting from Chengdu. It's just a little gift. I didn't want to just ask for money, because that's just a lame one. I don't really need to keep asking for money every time. So start importing lacquer and jade from Chengdu, and start making lacquerware so we can start evolving this housing area so we can put down more forts. So I'll let this run. I'll come back in if anything interesting happens. So here's our house is now evolving to Heavenly Compound immediately, because we've imported some tea, made some lacquer, and right up to Heavenly Compound. So once all these houses stabilise, we'll meet the returning Kaifeng's goal of 150 people in Heavenly Compound. I've just realised that this is connected to all of this, which is disconnected from the rest of the city. So I've had to put a little wall in here so that they can just get straight through to the jades, can't get the jades and bring it back for use in the city. In use for this story. So we'll get that going, and that'll give us another export. Hongdi's arrived. Yes, I know, I gave him some stuff and he's got happy from it. So now we need to conquer 3 more cities. We've got loads of heroes in the city that we don't really need, so let's start conquering more cities. Yuzhang and Tanzhou are the best ones to capture, simply because that when you return here, these two cities no longer exist. Now we're just Chizhou, but we'll keep Chizhou because they're an ally to us. We don't really want to be conquering an ally. So we'll go for Jiangling, I think, shortly, just to get them happy. Chengdu went to Loyal after I gave them that gift of wheat, which was good. So now that we have all these things here, we can now build up our military, and the game is glitching the troops again. It doesn't register that we have troops, even though we do have the space for more heavenly. We've got heavenly compounds here. It doesn't register them for some reason. So I'll let this run, and I'll start building up more forces and start trying to conquer more cities. Okay, so our forces are building up. The forts eventually place. So I should actually get this fort right tucked in here, which is good. That means I've got space here for putting more stuff if I really need it. I had to put down another jade carver and stop importing jade, because we're importing, the amount that we're importing means that we can't accept the gift that we get from Chengdu every so often, which is not helpful. I might just toggle the imports on and off as I need them. But we're selling the carved jade off to Guangzhou now, making massive profit. We've got loads of lacquerware to sell, actually. Does anyone buy it? I don't think anyone... Well, I think there's one city that buys it, which is Tanzhou, which we're not really going to bother with as a trading city, because they disappear anyway. So other than Tanzhou, I'm not going to bother with lacquerware at the moment. We do need it later, but it's not so important right now. In fact, I don't even think we'll need it later. So we're going to go and send troops to go and conquer Tanzhou now. I'm just going to send some paper to Hongdi to keep him happy, and then we'll send off stuff to Thingy. I'll send off troops to Tanjo and conquer them and get towards these goals. We've got 57 of 36 months, that's been pretty good. So the city is now basically stable. It's now a case of me sending off all the troops I need to conquer the various cities I need to win the mission. So I'll come back in when we're about to conquer Tanjo. Okay, so Sun Tzu is back in the city now. We're going to send off loads of troops. I'm literally going to send off half my city's forces just to conquer Tanjo. So we're going to send off 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's 9, 10, 11. One's not got anything in it, but that's okay. We're not going to demand anything out of Tanjo because there's... we'll just demand cash out of them, it doesn't really matter. Because they don't, we can import lacquer from Chengdu, we don't need to import silk, we're already importing rice. I might have to import rice from other cities though, because I know that Tanjo and Tizhou disappear, so I might have to import rice from Guangzhou instead. But well, that doesn't matter, so we'll just go and dispatch those troops, and there we go, they're off. Yes, because two of our forts are, one of the forts is empty at the moment, but this will allow them to stabilise, so that's okay. So, troops are off, I'll come back in once Tanjo is conquered. Tanjo has been conquered. I'm pretty sure that this thing with the type that the leader is a mistake, because that's another city that's apparently run by An Guo. I think it's just that it's been hard-coded possibly to that city, which is not what we want. We're going to send Tanjo some lacquerware, since we've got plenty of it. 8 lacquerware vessels, that'll keep you happy. We're not going to import anything off of you, but it's okay. So that's just conquered Tanjo. The troops will come back, and I'll come back in once we're about to send off troops to conquer Yuzhang. Okay, so we're going to go and conquer Yuzhang now. So we'll just go and send off those troops yet again to go and conquer another city. Because these have got... one shield is a matter. Now Tanjo and Chengdu now have a second shield, that's only because of the fact that they are now vassals, they're just automatically building up their forces as a result. So we're gonna send off loads of troops, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 to with Sun Tzu. We're not gonna really bother with tribute with them either because they'll disappear as well. So I'm only sending custom tribute types to the cities that actually stay by the time we come back here. So there we go, off you go, and you can leave it in peace. So I'll come back here once Yuzhang is conquered again. And Yuzhang is now a vassal. Wu Da Cheng is ashamed, yes. So that's our troops coming back, which is good. Opinion has apparently plummeted of us. We're now down to well light. I think it's because we didn't hold the festival or something. They just got really, really mad. The game's weird like that. It decides that it wants to plummet the opinion just because of that. So we've got three cities now conquered. And... oh, Tanjo is bitter again. They've all gone bitter because I conquered someone else. I'm not sure what that's about. So we'll send off... what was it we had to send off? 8 bushels of wheat. That'll keep them happy, I think. We'll send off 8 lacquerware vessels to Tanjo and to Yuzhang. We will send 8 baskets of cabbage. That'll keep you all happy, I think, and prevent them from rebelling. Because if they start rebelling, I'm going to have to use military force to get to quell that. I don't really want that. So I'll come back in once our troops return and we're about to conquer the final city. So our troops have arrived back. Unfortunately, I noticed that all the troops to be sent, they've all lost 3 troops. So I'm going to have to wait for them to build up again before I send any more off to conquer the last city that I need to meet the goals. I didn't mention, but I evolved this house in one because we had some worker shortages. So we've got a 9% unemployment, which is just okay. I will have to obviously make use of this high unemployment to be able to build the monument that we have to do when we come back here. I did send stuff off to Yuzhang, but they... were still bitter, but they've gone loyal now, even though I haven't heard anything back from their second gift of cabbage that I sent to them, so maybe it's just a glitch, I don't know. Still making a lot of carved jade, not tons, but we're making some. I'll probably use most of this side for making the monument, or this little bit up here, I don't know, but the work camps are right pain in the neck to place, as you know, because of the feng shui crap, so let's just destroy that bit of rubble. Just there. Yuzhang's grateful for that cabbage, that's good. Let's see, what are they rating of us? Still loyal, that's okay, so... and that's a broken spy map. So we're now just going to conquer the last city, and I'll come back in when we're near the end of the mission, because it's only just one city we have to conquer. I have to wait for the troops to build up again. Once they have, I'll get Sun Tzu back into the city, and then we'll go and conquer Jiangling. So we're about to go and conquer one more city, and that will be Jiangling, and then we'll be done with this mission. So let's head off all our troops. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And because they are important to us, I'm going to set their tribute type to wood. We're going to ask them to gift us planks of... not planks of wood, because we'd have to import that. Let's go with gifts of... Well, actually, let's not bother with any of these, because salt we're not going to need, because we'll still need salt. So let's just set the thing to salt. We'll just set it to a mild one, and that means we won't have to import so much salt. Tea and wood have to be imported so they don't go into a special storage yard, and hemp we can grow manually anyway. So we can apparently also send troops to Tanjo, apparently, because they've got a couple of shields. I don't know what that's about, but we're not having troops from other cities, other vassals, doing anything here. So we'll set off all these troops and Sun Tzu to conquer Jiangling, and then we will be winning this mission. So I like this mission, it's actually not too bad. I just forgot that when we come back to this city, we won't need to import jade from Chengdu anymore, because a new trading post will appear by that time, so we won't have to worry too much about jade imports. So then I won't have to use this method of getting jade all the way up here without any issues, so it won't be too big of a deal. So I enjoyed this mission. When we come back here, we'll have a nice big city to work with. Unfortunately, our funds will be reset for no apparent reason to the game. So we will be starting with 116,000 strings of cash on return here, but I like this mission because it's all about rushing to build some forts to deal with the early invasions. But it is tough because it's a rush to build all the forts that you need, so you will need elite housing. I know there's no goal for it, but you will need elite housing here, whether you like it or not. So don't try to conquer cities with two forts. You will need some elite housing. I recommend building the 6, because then you just get straight to the goal for when you come back here and hold the festival. And yeah, we'll just have to wait for our troops to come back from Jiangling, and hopefully they've conquered Jiangling without any issues. Tanjo, they're paying a really high tribute money. 540 strings of cash is pretty nice, and we can't get the jade because it's all stockpiling in here now, which is not too good, because we're not selling enough carved jade, I think, so that's the problem. We've imported a lot and it's not getting used up, which is a shame, but never mind. And if that stays out of there long enough, which it won't be, if all of these can clear up, then that'll help. And then we'll be able to get out of this issue. I don't think it'll be too much of a big deal, because we'll be winning the mission shortly any case. Come on, give me the victory screen. Speed this up a bit. There we go!
Congratulations, Son of Heaven. You have reunited China and founded the Song Dynasty. May its glory surpass those of all our ancestors. Your deeds are so great that the people have begun calling you Taizu, the Supreme Progenitor.
Well, that's a nice title, but it doesn't matter. So, in the next mission, we are going to head to Pingyao to capture more cities, but another threat to China awakens when we go to Pingyao. Thanks for watching, and see you at Pingyao. Bye now.